every week of Great Lent as its own theme. You see, the services of Great Lent have a special and whole composition. If we look at them from an artistic point of view, there is a general composition, which has its own culmination in the Paschal service, but at the same time has some specific stages. Every Sunday, each week, represents a step, a milestone that we pass. The third week of Lent is called the Week of the Cross. Is the midpoint of the fast. Why is it so special? The thing is that on Saturday evening, the cross is brought out to the center of the church and left there for the whole week. Then it will be returned to the altar on Friday. The services during this period are united by themes devoted to the cross, the suffering on the cross. The cross as a weapon with which the Lord defeats death. We can say that this weapon gives us strength to triumph in our personal spiritual battles. I have no remarkable experience connected with the cross. I only remember a simple episode, which nevertheless made a deep impression on me. I used to go to church only on Sundays, even during Great Lent. Consequently, I knew nothing about the Lenten services. I think that there are many people who have no opportunity to experience this because of their work and their busy schedules. I remember clearly that I came to church on one Sunday, and at that moment, when the Trisagion hymn should be sung at the liturgy, the choir sang, "Thy cross do we adore, O Master." When I heard this hymn, a special feeling engulfed me. Well, perhaps it was connected with something. It is hard for me to say what it was. Something deep. Maybe the chant itself, the way it was sung, the people around who began to make prostrations. All these things amazed me somehow, because I had never seen something like that before. Remember that I was very impressed by it. Although I did not know that it was the week of the cross and why we sang this special hymn, but it was my experience. You know, I have two small children, and when they see any cross, for example, on the doctor's bag or in a book, they begin to venerate it, although it has no connection with religion at all. Children just understand that a cross is something worthy of veneration. Our whole life is filled with the cross, and Christians wear small crosses around their necks, although this is a more recent tradition. Christian churches are decorated with crosses. We can see crosses inside and outside churches and on icons. Of course, Apostle Paul says that the cross is to the Jews a stumbling block and to the Greeks foolishness. If we speak about suffering from the human point of view, then we can say that people do not always understand their meaning. For example, I often notice during the sacrament of baptism that people cannot accept the words said in these prayers. There are words saying that we baptize a person into death, Christ's death. To imagine yourself as one of the parents who has come to have their child baptized so that he will stay healthy, that the child study well and his life is under the protection of God's grace. How can we say that we are going to baptize this child into death? Of course, for such people, everything related to carrying their own cross, some things may not be properly interpreted. More often, a person will try to avoid any sort of suffering. Suffering, however, is the only path for a spiritual person. To the extent that we consider ourselves Christian, everyone is on a path to their personal Golgotha. It is a necessity. Without our cross, we simply cannot come to our resurrection. In order for us to be resurrected, we must die on the cross. It is a Christ's path in which we participate in a miniature way, everyone to some extent. Every Christian must at least in a small manner. If he wants to be with Christ, then we must be a part of his suffering, crucifixion, and resurrection.